Testing.
I welcome once again as we get set. Boy, what a quick change. Yeah, be a quick change artist as well as a broadcaster to get these things done. Hey, Mike McGarry, Devin Dixon, Andy Griffin tonight as we get set to bring you the semifinal action from the brand new, with the semifinals of the 3A. There we go, here in Cedar City. And we got a good one coming up. Boy, what a lot of action we have seen here today, guys, and it's just going to keep on running.
Well, this is kind of the featured event, is it not, boys? I mean, we've been looking forward to seeing the Dixie Flyers, the only team left out of Southern Utah that can win a state championship. They got there last year, only to lose by 3 to the Pine View Panthers, and they're right where they want to be here at the Centrum. But there's a Bear River team that comes in with a lot of momentum, snuck out a 7-point deficit for a win in Richfield, and then a nice win yesterday to get into the semifinals, and they're playing with a lot of confidence.
Yeah, and we've seen some not so close games today, but we just saw a great one, and it'll be interesting to see if Bear River and Dixie can put together the kind of contest we just saw with Cedar pulling out the buzzer beater in the girls semis. Girls championship, Snow Canyon, Cedar, those two teams split on the regular season. That should be good. And then we're about to find out, fellas, who's in the boys championship.
Yeah, of course, this is the first of two. Later on tonight, Canyonview 1, Diego. A lot of people before the tournament started, as we officially welcome into the locker room pregame show, that there would be Dixie and Juan Diego there on opposite sides of the bracket. But tonight, we'll find out as we get ready to go.
Yeah, it's always such a fun thing to see these championships because, you know, you can look at them and say, yeah, we think this is going to happen. You never know until you put the teams on the court. And you have that, but these are two very good teams. I do know one thing, there is a little bit of a concern, maybe a lot of concern, when it comes to the matchups, how these two teams match up, because Bear River, big, tough, physical. Dixie, maybe a little bit more to the sharpshooter kind of a team.
Well, you look at the 17-point win for Bear River yesterday, and they did it with defense, and that 1-3-1 zone really disrupted Justin Loveless and Snow Canyon's Kobe Tupu, and they just couldn't get anything going. I mean, it was, 19-3, 25-5, and they never really looked back. I mean, Snow Canyon cut it to 10 late. And they didn't make a three in the game, so Bear River likes to go inside, and they like to play really good pressure defense.
Yeah, and this Bears team, remember they finished third in their region behind Juan Diego and behind Logan, but we know how good those two teams are. And so, for the Bears, I think that the up-tempo really is something they want to do in this ball game. They do play great defense, you're right, but I think Snow Canyon has the best defense in the state.
Well, as you say, we are about to find out on all of those points there as we sit and watch this one here this evening. So we're excited about it. We're glad to be here. The place is filling up. A good contingent of Flyer fans. I think Bear River brought down quite a few. But this is where it really starts to get interesting. This is where the kids got to lay it out on the court.
You got some premier players out there, but the best player on the court throughout this season has been Tyler Bennett. Tyler Bennett has been simply unstoppable at times this year, and I can't wait to see what he's capable of in this one because he played hurt in the state tournament last year. He had a game winner against Bear River. Do you remember that, guys? It was like a half-court bank shot that went in, and Bear River probably hasn't forgot that, but they got some talent of their own. I mean, the point guard Tristan Hartfell is very capable. He had a game winner last Saturday against Richfield. So there's some talent on the floor for both teams for certain.
Our pregame tonight brought to you by the Locker Room, and the game starts in nearly the Locker Room, 514 North Bluff Street. Everything for the athlete at the Locker Room. Dixie has had this in mind since almost exactly 1 year ago today when they lost that championship game to the hated Pine View Panthers. And I know, we all know that Dixie has been very single-minded this year. Very little celebration when they clinched the region championship. They didn't cut down the nets because they did it at home. They clinched the number one seed. They didn't do anything like that because they got a bigger fish to fry. That fish is right out there right now. It's actually a bear, I guess, instead of a fish.
All right, let's take a two-minute break. We'll come back, get ready, starting lineups, and we'll tip it off here tonight from the Centrum, Southern Utah University. Two-minute break. We'll be back with all that right after this.
For just $4, get a double cheeseburger, a spicy chicken sandwich, fries, and a Coke. It's the heavyweight champion of deals. The $4 Real Deal, only at Carl's Jr. All the flavors of a great steakhouse, now on a burger. The Steakhouse Thick Burger. Onion strings, blue cheese, and A1 sauce on 100% Black Angus beef. Only at Carl's Jr.
With internet service from Centricom, you get a fast, reliable connection to a world of information and inspiration. Just choose the bandwidth package that fits your needs and your budget. Every package delivers consistent speeds that bring the best of the web into your life. And we offer local, over-the-phone, technical, and professional IT support. It's why Centricom is now our area's number one internet provider. Add internet to your bundle and save. Call or visit centricom.com today.
It is a good day to be alive in the STG.
You would have lost your mind!
I could not believe he didn't.
Southern Utah's connection to the world of sports is Sports Radio 97.7 ESPN. Southern Utah's home for the best in sports includes local high school games, Dixie State University, the NBA's new look, Utah Jazz, plus the best of the National Football League. With the worldwide presence of ESPN, to the Devin Dixon Show every afternoon from 4 to 6.
In times like these, a small business has to work smart to make it. Centricom can help. We've got the business class services you need for less. We're the fastest small business internet speeds available today. The reliability of 24-hour network monitoring and superior tech support. And our commitment to grow when you do with scalability that's both fast and flexible on our own fiber optic network. Make the smart choice. Call or visit centricom.com today.
Hi, welcome back. We are just a minute or so away from all the festivities. In fact, the starting lineups are much more coming your way. But right now, Devin, let's take a look at some of the keys to this semifinal action.
Yeah, presented by Camping World St. George, 1500 South Hilton Drive. The big sale going on all spring long on travel trailers and RVs, new and used. Go take a look or campingworldstgeorge.com. For Bear River, their transition D has got to be good tonight. They've got to keep the quick Dixie guards out of the middle, because when they get to the middle, Guyman gets dunks. And they've also got to limit the turnovers. For Dixie, they want to rebound and they want to run. They want an up-tempo pace, lots of ball movement. They'll run that weave right around the perimeter. They'll try to suck you out and then beat you to the rack off the bounce. And then they're unselfish. If they continue to share the basketball, it's not just Tyler Bennett. Open shots got to be hit by his teammates in this game if the Flyers are going to win.
Yeah, Dixie's got some good shooters. You know, Nate Crockett can throw it down. Connor Dykes from outside has been really good the second half of the season. But one thing Dixie has to remember on defense, don't lose the shooters. We saw Gunnar Sorensen go off yesterday against Snow Canyon. And then we know Tristan Hartfield is a guy who can shoot it from anywhere on the court. So keep track of those, especially those two guys who can really shoot it.
We are just about ready for the starting lineups here this evening. Dixie, of course, in their white unis. Bear River in their dark red with the black trim. And good-sized crowd on hand here tonight for this game. And, of course, a game yet to come tonight will be the, quote, unofficial home team here with the Falcons. And they're excited, obviously, to be right here in their hometown.
Yeah, Mike, it should fill out really big about quarter to nine when all the Canyon View fans show up. And we already have a big crowd. When you get the Canyon View folks in here and Juan Diego, this place is going to be packed.
Absolutely rocking here. So they're going through the starting lineups of the two teams here tonight. And for those joining us on radio in the St. George area, we are pretty much used to the players for us from Dixie. And I'm sure they won't be changing anything as we see the introductions going on. Tyler Bennett, averaging a little over 22 points a ball game out there. Also, James Erdley, my junkyard dog kind of a guy. I love seeing the excitement of Richard Guyman, who I again think has been one of the most improved players in the conference, maybe in the state. The guy's really stepped it up.
You know, when he played against a seven-footer that's going to Gonzaga, when they played Bishop Gorman, he held his own. You're right, Mike.
He's really doing good. Nate Crockett, the rifleman, will line it up and knock it down. And, of course, starting point guard Malachi Otis, got to be one of the quickest, best defenders around.
And one quick note about Erdley. You know, I had someone ask me yesterday after the game, who's that 23 guy? Because he's everywhere on the court. I agree with him. James Erdley is that guy that does all the little things that makes Dixie successful.
Go ahead.
I was going to say, but Bear River's got some guys that can do kind of like Erdley. They're kind of a blue-collar team like he is.
Absolutely. Love to see that. All right. At 6'4", Michael Litchford, Nate Dahl at 6'3" tall, the senior, wears number 20. Gunnar Sorensen, you talked about him, a forward, a junior.
He right went off, yeah.
What's that?
He went off yesterday.
Yeah, the guy can flat shoot the basketball. Buse Bridger. I get that wrong. Bridger Buse. There we go. The 5'11 senior guard. And I know I left one. There he is, Tristan Hartfell. Can't forget that guy.
Yeah, he's their leading scorer and a guy that can also fill it up from outside, Mike.
All right, so there you go, starting lineups. Again, we appreciate, again, the great golf course out there. Hit it to the sky at Sky Mountain. Officials are ready. We're ready. Let's go. Big crowd on hand. Thanks for joining us along the internet and, of course, on radio. The tip is up. It is controlled by the Flyers. In the backcourt, Malachi Otis walks back into the forecourt and can immediately go in to the weave. Back and forth across the top of the key. To the near wing, handed to Erdley. Erdley back across, they work left side. Otis, they'll just do that and then they'll try to lull you to sleep. And there it is, Erdley finds it, goes down, reverse it up and in.
And I love how he used the rim as kind of a rim protector. He went up and under with the reverse, so there was no chance the Bears could block that shot.
Whoa, whoa, Junkyard Dog gets the first bucket.
In the backcourt, Hartfell with the ball, now hands it back to Buse. Buse on the wing left side, goes straight away, Hartfell. Hartfell stops, looks inside, fakes the three, now gives it up and gets it right back. We're just underway, 2-0 Dixie. Down low in the lane, shot no, taken away by Dixie. Coming away with it is Bennett. Quickly in the forecourt, Otis with a little no-look pass back to Bennett. Bennett again, he lays it up and in.
Give and go, it's the oldest play in the book, Mike.
Gotta love that.
Yeah, it's a great start for the Flyers. Bear River's got to be careful to get quality possessions because this is a Dixie team that can run away from about anybody in the state.
Bears with the basketball. They trail 4-0. Kick out, lining up a triple. Hard off the back rim. Battle and hey, the little guy.
That's a great rebound for Otis.
To Bennett. Bennett swings it up to Otis. Down the lane. Triple on the way. It's off the mark. Rebound hauled in by Dahl.
That's adrenaline. Malachi, usually pretty good shot selection, but that's adrenaline pumping through his veins right there.
Yeah, I think you forgot to check the wind on that one because it blew it a little bit left.
You know what? He's worked really hard on becoming a better shooter, though, and he's proved that this year, but that one didn't fall.
Bounce it inside. Kick back again. A team D out of triple. No, off the mark. Ball is slapped down. Malachi runs out and actually stepped on the line. Should have let it go.
Yeah, that was going to be off the Bears.
Yeah.
I think what happened was as he turned to pivot, the back foot swung around and just caught the back of that heel on the line.
So the Bears will have the ball. They trail 4-0. We've played about 2 minutes here in the first quarter of this one. Down in the corner they go. Underneath. Double up, swings it up the left hand. No, we got a travel. Trying to get out of there was Hartfell.
Has kind of poked his head out of the mess, and as he did it, he moved his feet.
So it'll be a Flyer basketball. Otis into the forecourt. He works off to the left side, hands it to Bennett. Bennett reverses, spin in the lane, kick out. Team Diotto three across and off, no good. To the floor, the rebound. Bears pick it up, they're running. Stop, pop. Boy, they're hitting long ones. I mean, they're shooting long ones. They're not hitting. Ball knocked out, Crockett. On the miss, kicks it back to Otis. Otis, Bennett underneath, lay it up and in.
So smart by Crockett, pull it out, and then boom, get it to your point guard, who boom, gets it to Tyler Bennett. Bear River needs a T.O. Coach Scott Hunt doesn't like what he sees. 6-0 Flyers.
Yeah, what he's seeing is the Flyers off and running here in this one. And is it just a third? Let's take a quick 30-second break. 6-0 Flyers, back in a half a minute.
Logan Regional Orthopedics provides excellent care, all the resources available.
Having a full-service hospital so close is very helpful.
I think our level of caring and expertise set us apart.
We've stayed current, and we've demonstrated that we are certified.
We offer patients the ability to treat almost anything here in the Valley.
Everybody is committed to providing you the best quality of care to allow you to get back and doing the things that you want to do.
Logan Regional Orthopedics and Sports Medicine, healing for life.
Hi, welcome back as we get set. 5:16 to go here in the first quarter after the timeout. Bears will have the ball in backcourt, and I think Bridger Buse may have touched the ball for the first time. Then he hands it right back to Hartfell. Tristan Hartfell on the wing near side. Caleb Jensen, who just checked into the ball game. And they swing it up right back to Jensen. Midway the corner left side, down underneath to Litchford, loses the ball, gets it back, kicks it out, trying to bounce it in the corner. They get there. Dixie quickly on that swarming defense. Now we have a reach and a foul whistled on Malachi Otis.
Yeah, a little hand check, ticky-tack foul, but this Dixie defense has really been good so far. Mike, you know, that's one thing that we always forget about with Dixie, because they can shoot, they can dunk. It's probably the most dunking team in the region. It may be in the state in 3A. But their best thing really is their defense. We saw them hold Stansberry to 8-minute stretch without any points in the first and second quarter last week.
Ball comes across court, banks it in from the outside.
He meant to do that, right?
He did. Caleb Jensen with the triple, the other end, getting it right back is Crockett.
Anything you can do, I can do better, Crockett says. That wasn't very close either. That was way out there, and he didn't have to use the bank.
That's right. 9-3, Flyers take it away. Inside, quickly ahead to Bennett. Bennett in the forecourt, Elzy. He rises on the way, crossed and off, no good. Rebound underneath, taken away by Gunnar Sorensen.
Elzy put in some really good minutes yesterday in their victory over Logan.
Back to back, no, almost got it, but the reach up and a foul is going to be whistled on Crockett. Crockett on the reach in will get his first personal, second team foul on Dixie.
Yeah, he knew it too. He's just like, I didn't mean to do that. Connor Dykes will come in his place, and Dykes is every bit as dangerous as Crockett from deep.
Depth has been a big help, obviously, to the Flyers this year as well. They got some good guys they bring off the bench. Ball comes out to Litchford. Shot at no, up top high, rips the rebound down is Richard Guyman.
Not a good start for Hartfell. That's not good for the Bears. He's 0-for-3 from downtown.
Muscle shot, in goes Bennett, lays it up good.
That's why it's so hard to define, Tyler Bennett. Is he a driver? Yeah. Is he a shooter? Yeah. Can he power it when he needs to? Well, we just saw it right there, didn't we?
Absolutely. And the second team D-auto by Caleb Jensen. He's 2-for-3 on the arc. Inside kick out. Underneath. Hammer dump. They got it down to Guyman.
What a helper. Well, I was on the same page as you, Andy. Erdley elevates and then two-hand whip pass, and Diamond knows what to do. Straight flush.
Yeah, he was up, and he was staring down inside the hoop, I think, when he was up there.
Team D-Auto 3. The Bears can shoot from outside.
Hartfell. Yeah, that's the guy we were wondering about. And he can shoot it, and he's going to keep shooting it, I promise.
13-9.
That's good for the Bears. After that rough start, they needed him to get one through the net.
Dykes in there, get it around to Bennett on the angle right. Bennett looks low, nobody there. Swings it up to Elzy. He starts to drive, cuts off early. Now outside Dykes underneath to the big guy. Turn off the glass. No, won't go down. Inside rebound Sorensen. Bears take it. The other way. 2:35 to go, first quarter. Boy, they're not afraid to shoot it. They cross that half court line and they start looking for the shot. Bennett says, I'm going all the way. And what do we got? Jump ball.
Boy, that's one of the first times all year I've seen anybody go up with Tyler and get their hands on the ball only.
I kept waiting for Tyler to go to that signature spin move. Yeah. And he just kind of kept coasting down the lane, and then this quick snare to grab it. That was a great defensive play by Bear River to stop a transition bucket from one of the best at getting lay-ins at the rim.
We don't call him the finisher for nothing, do we?
And he'll sit down, take a little breather in this one. 2:18 to go, first quarter, 13-9. Flyers lead over the Bear River Bears. Way outside with the basketball. Bounce to the high post. They Kick it back out to Hartfell. Hartfell in the corner gets it back on the angle. All over him is Dykes on the defense. Keeping pretty close to him, but he turns, reverses back to the near wing, Sorensen. Down low. Oh, I think he traveled on that one and they got him.
I think that there's about 3,500 folks in this stadium that knew that he traveled on that play.
Bennett didn't sit long, did he, fellas? Tyler Bennett, Flyer star, averaging over 22 points a game, right back in there.
So was that a settle him down type thing? Just pull him out and say, settle down just a minute, Tyler, because he was a little bit pumped.
Well, I think it's just to get some water and then get back out there. These guys are young. They got a lot of energy, but certainly he was hurt during the state tournament. This year, he's a lot more healthy.
Bennett across the top of the key. Now we've got a reach and a foul.
Boy, they set up a three-pointer on that play perfectly. You know, nice little drive-in dish, but the ref stopped it before we could see if that was going to go in.
Buse with the first personal, that's first team foul on the Bears, as back into the ball game now is Nate Dahl sitting down, Caleb Jensen. Buse, Coach Hunt, I'd keep Jensen on the string, getting back in. He's got six of the 8 points.
Well, that was a quick five, wasn't it, guys?
I didn't count it out myself, but it did seem like it was.
Just a minute. Five. Yeah, I thought it was a little quick.
1, 2, 5.
Something like that.
But Bear Rivers kind of weathered the storm, fellas.
Absolutely.
Only down four, you know, right there where they want to be down the stretch here in the first quarter.
1.5 minutes to go. A catch and shoot. Hard off the back rim. No good. Ball tipped out. Taken by Otis. In the forecourt, reach back to Bennett. Bennett in the corner, now out to Otis. Malachi, little dribbling exhibition in the lane, step back, no shot there.
Well, he'll usually shoot that fadeaway.
He will.
About 15 feet out, that's his shot.
Coming out to the high post, Guyman gets it. Gives it up to Erdley. Now Bennett comes out. They may just run some time. It's a minute remaining here, and Dixie, well, they're not going to do that.
That's why Connor Dykes can hit.
Oh, he was way out there. Another Team Diato three. Down it goes, and it's 16-9 Flyers. High post kick out, catch and shoot, answering.
Wow, it's a three for all of a sudden. Everybody getting in on the act. A lot of Team Diato sales triples in this first quarter.
All 12 points for the Bears from beyond the arc. Four triples. Now the Flyers definitely are just going to hold to the end of the first quarter, just standing with the ball on hip at half court, Malachi Otis.
Well, this is not unusual. They value every possession. We've seen this in region games throughout the year.
At 10, they should go. There it is, and they start to move, trying to set it up. Otis looks to the left. Back underneath Bennett. Bennett throws it up. Oh, and he rolls back in. Bennett will get credit for the bucket.
Yeah, I don't know who was that up there high,
Guyman.
Devin.
Yeah, that was
wanted
Guyman.
To touch it, but he said, I better keep my hands off. Good decision.
How did he make that shot, though? He's falling down. He flips it up, and he gets the roll. Good quarter for the Flyers.
18-12 in favor of the Flyers. End of one. We're back in a minute.
The living room. It's a great place to watch TV. Just like your backyard, break time at the office, or while on the go. Now you can watch TV everywhere. Stream your favorite shows or live TV from many channels in your cable package on any computer, tablet, or smartphone. It's all included with Centricom Cable TV service for no extra cost. Sign up to watch TV everywhere today. Call or visit centricom.com to learn more.
For just $4, get a double cheeseburger, a spicy chicken sandwich, fries, and a Coke. It's the heavyweight champion of deals. The $4 Real Deal, only at Carl's Jr. All the flavors of a great steakhouse, now on a burger. The Steakhouse Thick Burger. Onion strings, blue cheese, and A1 sauce on 100% black Angus beef. Only at Carl's Jr.
8 minutes back on the clock. Welcome back as we get set for the second quarter. There you have it. 18-12 Flyers with a 6-point lead.
Congratulations to four Dixie Flyers. To this really cool. Four all-academic basketball players. Nate Crockett, James Erdley, Tyler Bennett, and Zach one Hara. More. Zach Hara, thank you. Four, it leads all schools in all classifications in the state. Nobody had that many.
Unbelievable. In fact, almost half the entire all-academic team wears blue and white.
Shot by Bennett was no good. The rebound to the Bears were at the other end, and there's another three. Nate, and we understand Dolly, the correct pronunciation. We'll go with that.
Dolly? Dolly, yep.
That was a big three.
Like Sally.
How about five threes for their 15 points? How long can that streak keep going?
Well, so far, so good. Bennett will crash in the lane. Oh. Finger roll it up and in.
Bennett with 12, and you got to keep him out of the middle. You got to keep him in front. I know it's hard, but you can't let him get right to the middle of the floor. It's just too easy for the finger roll.
That's a back door on the cut. Good defense by Dixie. But wow, another great pull up. I think it was inside the line, right?
Yep, finally. First field goal, a 2-point field goal of the game for the Bears, and they're hanging in there.
20-17, the lead is three for the Flyers. So what is this? The first team to miss a bucket loses? What's going on here? 6:39 to go here.
I like this pace though for Dixie, I do.
Otis throws it away. Went down the far side. Bears were anticipating, they get it. He's gonna spot up, they let him shoot. It's off the mark, no good, and goes out of bounds. Come out there, Malachi Otis on the run, but he got there late. Fortunately for the Flyers, it didn't go down.
Yeah, I'm impressed with Bear River staying with Dixie, because Dixie's played good defense. And they played some pretty good offense so far, but the Bears right now just kind of hanging in this thing, and they're doing it with outside shooting.
LZ back and forth across the top of the key with Malachi Otis. Otis to LZ. LZ says, I'll shoot deep. No, off the mark. Up high for the rebound, but he loses it. Was Guyman. Bears come up with it. Ahead they go. Drive to the hole on the glass. No, but they're going to give him the bucket, right?
I think they're going to call a goaltend because Dixie slapped the backboard.
Who shot that? I'm
Dolly. Or no, it was Gunnar Sorensen, 15, I believe, Mike.
All right, we'll give Sorensen a bucket. It was awfully close, up high, and it's a one-point game, 20-19. You kind of had to figure that pace wouldn't continue, but wow. What a start.
As folks are watching this game, if you want to help us select our Dats Trucking player of the game, send us a tweet using the hashtag Dats Trucking, and we'll name it in our post-game show.
Flyers with the ball now in a one-point lead. Way out high. Bears extending that defense out to the three-point line, not allowing the Flyers any penetration. Now they get it down in the corner. Crockett, and he travels with the ball.
Bears have played a lot of man-to-man in the first quarter. They've now switched to a zone, a 2-3 zone. And Dixie, I think, maybe a little bit confused on the switch. Wasn't ready for it.
Caught off guard, absolutely. They had to stay a long way away from the bucket. 5:23 to go, first half. 2019 Flyers up one. Bears, though, with the ball. And they can shoot from anywhere on the court. They go down low, lean in. Shot short, no good. Rebound taken down inside.
Yeah, Larkin's in there.
Yep.
Played good defense and then got the rebound.
To Bennett. Bennett rises hard off the back rim. No good. Rebound hauled in by Dolly. 2019, under five to go here in the first quarter of, or first half of action. Bounce at high post. Oh, anticipation. Early nearly had it. Now we have a travel.
Yeah, Early didn't get the steal, but he really did force a turnover by forcing the offensive player to panic a little bit.
The ball will be out of bounds in front of the Dixie bench. Bennett will inbound the ball, looking to get it. Malachi Otis. Otis, a quick little senior point guard for the Flyers. Still in that matchup zone. They go underneath and back out again. Looking around the horn. Pretty good job by the Bears to jump the passing routes as well.
It's like a 1-3-1 zone, huh?
Yep.
Got somebody coming in way out high.
Yep.
They don't want to suck out too far, though. They've watched a lot of film. I'm sure they've seen when teams try to extend, that allows Dixie to get to the middle and beat them off the bounce.
Start to drive. No shot there. They kick it out. Back to Crockett. In the corner it goes early. Back to Crockett. Drive, hang, shot, short off the rim, no good. Rebound battled for, and we're going to have a foul whistled on Malachi Oda.
This is the defense Bear River really started the game with against Snow Canyon and really caused him so many troubles. Now, Malachi Otis did get a look there, just didn't finish, and then he converted the foul.
Yeah, and that's two fouls on Oda, something to keep an eye on in this game. The starting point guard for Dixie High will sit down, though. Although I will say this, Elzy has played well lately.
You know, he didn't play a lot pre-Christmas at all. And then in region games, he kept playing and playing, and there he gets a steal. He's been getting better and better.
Elzy stopped, throws it away. Thrown right back, but it's saved by the Bears as Dolly comes up with it. They go down, bounce it underneath. Shot up off the rim is in the bucket by Sorensen, and the Bears with a lead.
We got a ball game, boys.
That was an HQA, a high-quality assist on that one, wasn't it?
Amen.
Beautiful bounce pass.
3.5 to go here in the second quarter. Bad pass stolen away. Off to the races, layup good.
Man, Sorensen running and gunning. Gunnar Sorensen right now. The steal, the thievery, and the lay-in. The Bears force the Flyers into a Rolling Stone timeout.
30-second break. We'll take it. 23-20 Bears back in 30.
It's a good day to be alive in the STG. Utilize your mind!
I could not believe he didn't.
Southern Utah's connection to the world of sports is Sports Radio 97.7 ESPN. Southern Utah's home for the best in sports includes local high school games, Dixie State University, the NBA's new look, Utah Jazz, plus the best of the National Football League. With the worldwide presence of ESPN, to the Devin Dixon Show every afternoon from 4 to 6.
All right, we welcome you back. 3.5 minutes to go here in the first quarter. 23-20 is the score, and the Bear River Bears to come back to retake the lead. Flyers trailing now, have the basketball. Elzy on the angle, right, goes left side. Deep, Team Diotto three is in and out, no good. Ball is tipped. Erdley comes up with a lean back shot, won't go down. And a rebound ripped out of there by the Bears. So walking it now in the backcourt. Under three to go. And taking their time in the forecourt, Hartfell. Into the game now is Marshall Pond for the Bears. Ball is tapped, but run down by the Bears. Hartfell goes back and gets it. Elzy comes out on a tight man-to-man. They go to Pond. Boy, Pond lays a crusher and gets it down low. Bridger Buse lays it up and in.
Wow, what is that about? A 9-0 run right now for the Bears?
And since they went to this zone, guys, have you noticed that about the last 3 minutes? The zone has really disrupted the offensive rhythm for the Flyers.
Dixie spreading the ball. Back to Elzy, fakes the three, starts to the corner. Skip pass. Ball's going to be tipped and knocked out of bounds. It belongs to the Flyers. Bears thought they had it. 2:08 to go in the first half. A 5-point lead now for Bear River.
Bear River playing with a lot of energy right now. They're really playing inspired. Coach Hunt has prepared them well for this game. Remember, this was both these teams played before noon yesterday morning, so they had a little extra time to get ready for this one all day today.
Yeah, a little nap time in the afternoon. Huh?
A little shoot around, study the scouting report, and both teams look fresh.
Richard Guyman checks back into the ball game for Dixie. Crockett on the angle, up top around to Bennett. Bennett midway the corner, cross court Elzy, back to Bennett, he'll penetrate. No shot, Elzy to Bennett. Bounce to the baseline. Back to Bennett.
You gotta move the ball quickly, that's how you beat this zone. Quick passing and penetration.
1:42 to go. Dixie looking for an opening and the Bears not giving them one. Crockett to Elzy, to Crockett. Down on the baseline, back out Crockett. Nowhere to go inside. They do get it inside, then they throw it away. Pond with a steal. Into the forecourt, bounce it down, catch, shoot. Hard off the rim, no good, rebound battle for. Nice hustle and save by Bennett.
Long arms, reached that one.
Bennett penetrates, jump step, inside layup good.
Yeah, you can't get back to set up the zone when he grabs a rebound and runs. That was one of our Camping World keys. Nice job. Bennett's got 14 points in the first half.
He beat the on-ball defense with Hartfield and then shot it over to big guy.
to Pond at the high post, kicks it back out, Hartfell. Hartfell, bump, no foul, reaches in all alone down low as Dolly lays it up and in.
Give credit to the Bears, they set good screens.
27 to 22. Deep, Team Diotto comes off the rim, no good, and a rebound picked up by the Bears on the baseline right side. 25 seconds to go. Bears in control. They lead by five. Back and forth they go. Inside, jump step, feed down low, shot up and in. And Sorensen with 8 points all here in the quarter, and it's a 7-point margin.
Yeah, Dixie needs to get a shot. They only got 6 seconds. Got to go now.
Yeah, Bennett's going to step up. Now he throws. They don't know. They're not watching the clock. Unbelievable. They did not look up at the clock, and they just ran it out.
I think Bennett knew.
Right.
I think Bennett knew, but I don't think that anybody else knew on the floor, and that cost him. Hopefully we're trying to get Devin down there with Coach Cuff. You see him, Mike?
See that thing.
I don't see him anywhere.
I wonder if they disappeared into the tunnel.
I think they went there pretty quick. So 10 minutes, we're going to take a...
Okay, we got it. Here we go. He just waved at me.
So I don't know.
I'll tell you what though, Mike.
As I talked with Coach Cuff, but we were out of range. We went down the tunnel and he couldn't hear, but he said we got to keep the intensity up and we got to do a better job getting it against the zone. So look for the Flyers to come out, make some adjustments. Back up to you.
All right. Thanks a lot there.
Yeah, that zone was something else, and it really changed this game, didn't it?
Totally turned it around. Take a 90-second break. 90-second break right now. We'll be back with the halftime. 29-22 Bears here at the half.
Want to make your HD TV even better? Centricom has the HD channels you want. Our HD DVR gives you total control of your experience. And we're always adding new channels to serve you better. Why settle for less? Get our full HD lineup, now with over 61 HD channels. Call or visit us online and get the best HD experience from Centricom.
Logan Regional Orthopedics provides excellent care, all the resources available.
Having a full-service hospital so close is very helpful.
I think our level of caring and expertise set us apart.
We've stayed current, and we've demonstrated that we are certified.
We offer patients the ability to treat almost anything here in the Valley.
Everybody is committed to providing you the best quality of care to allow you to get back and doing the things that you want to do.
Logan Regional Orthopedics and Sports Medicine, healing for life.
High-speed Wi-Fi. Not quite as important as running water in your home, but close. Centricom powers your Wi-Fi network with consistent speeds to keep all your gadgets going strong. Streaming video players, laptops, tablets, even smartphones, so you're never stuck with those big cell data charges. And talk about value. Just pick your speed and keep the Wi-Fi flowing in your home at a great low price. Upgrade your internet today. Call or visit centricom.com to learn more.
Hi, welcome back to Cedar City, and boy, what a change in now when Flyers had an 18-12 lead at the half. They only scored 4 points in that second quarter, Andy, and all, well, the two buckets by Tyler Bennett, and now it is 29-22 Bears.
You know, Mike, one thing we learned about this region, it has Juan Diego and Logan and Bear River, they score points. These teams yeah. know how to put points on the board. So if you have a lull in your scoring, and let's face it, Dixie had a hard time figuring out that Bear River 1-3-1 zone. You have a lull in scoring like that, they're not going to stop scoring, and you're going to find yourself in trouble. We saw, what, a 17-4 advantage in the quarter for the Bears?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5 Team Diotto threes for the Bear River Bears, only two for Dixie State or Dixie High School, and they hit them early in that. Let's take a quick look at our scoring here at the half. Again, our Wilkinson stat line looks like this. 8 points by a couple of players for Bear River. 4 buckets by Gunnar Sorensen and his 8. Tristan Hartfell had two three-pointers and a two-pointer for 8, 5 points. Nate Daly, a bucket for 2, Bridger Buse, and then 2 long threes by Caleb Jensen in that first quarter. And frankly, he kind of came off the bench and gave him the offensive spark that they needed. 29 points. He did not shoot a free throw. I don't think we stopped long enough, did we, to shoot a free throw in the first?
No, nobody wants to shoot free throws. They just want to keep shooting those long bombs. By the way, our stats tonight brought to you by Wilkinson's, a unique place to shop in St. George. Of course, all your lighting needs, but also kind of a lot of fun specialty items like board games and things like that. Thanks so much to Wilkinson's for sponsoring our stats here.
Leading scorer in the game for either team is Tyler Bennett of Dixie. He has 6 buckets, 12 points. 8 of those points coming in the first quarter, and he had, as I mentioned, the only 4 points of the second quarter. Richard Guyman of a flush for 2, a deep 3, Connor Dykes, a bucket for 2, James Erdley, a deep 3 for Nate Crockett. That is it, 22 points at the half. Again, no free throws, and really not a lot of fouling. A very quick, clean, I say, first half, although it's very aggressive and very defensive. And I tell you what, we're seeing some absolutely fantastic shooting.
Yeah, you know, there's a lot of basketball game to go, 29-22 here at the half. There, you know, Dixie is going to score some points, but they've got to figure out how to get out to those shooters on defense, and they've got to absolutely have a plan for that zone. Quite frankly, Dixie looked a little bit confused in facing that 1-3-1 zone. Nobody wanted to take it on. And I sense some tentativeness from the shooters. Nate Crockett not flinging away from 3. That's his game.
And they didn't really ever run a guy around the high post. They had 2 guys down on baseline. They might have to put a big that floats around the middle and try to get him some entry passes at the high post. The problem is when you enter it into the high post, Erdley tried to go backdoor, and they got a steal. He was trying to find Guyman down on the baseline.
Yeah, quick hands, yep.
So you got to be really smart with your pass, and you can't just try a backhanded backdoor cut pass because it might not be there against a 1-3-1.
Yeah, well, good call.
That was a pretty quick discussion at the inside. I think coaches now get out there and do what I told you to do.
Well, yeah, if you're Bear River, you go in and you're feeling good. And all right, everybody drink some water. We're not going to change anything. If you're Dixie, it's a very pointed, very animated, very excited talk, and then get out there and get warmed up.
All right, so we are at the half once again. Now tomorrow, we have a lot more action coming here. It's going to be an all-Region 9 state championship game on the women's side as Snow Canyon Warriors will take on the Lady Reds of Cedar High. And they got a win here against Carbon. 1 point, I think, on a last-second lay-in that went up and in. So that's going to be exciting. We're finding out the first team is going to be in the men's final tomorrow. And then later tonight, you've got Juan Diego and
Canyonview,
thank you, going at it for the other team.
Yeah, good crowd. Now wait until about 9 o'clock tonight.
Well, they packed it yesterday afternoon, didn't they? They let the kids all out of school, Canyonview, the Falcons' Nest. Was alive. They were crowd surfing, Mike. I'd like to see you get some crowd surfing in later on.
Yeah, I think I'll just sit where I'm at. Thank you very much.
We don't want to kill anybody.
I know. Somebody yell whale.
Well, better
I'll
him
be
than
really
you.
Embarrassed.
I know. Well, that's what I mean.
Let's take a final 90-second break. We'll be back again getting ready for the second half. Have a quick look at what we think might need to happen. 29-22 Bear River at the half back in 90.
For just $4. Get a double cheeseburger, a spicy chicken sandwich, fries, and a Coke. It's the heavyweight champion of deals. The $4 real deal, only at Carl's Jr. All the flavors of a great steakhouse, now on a burger. The Steakhouse Thick Burger. Onion strings, blue cheese, and A1 sauce on 100% black Angus beef, only at Carl's Jr.
With internet service from Centricom, you get a fast, reliable connection to a world of information and inspiration. Just choose the bandwidth package that fits your needs and your budget. Every package delivers consistent speeds that bring the best of the web into your life. And we offer local, over-the-phone, technical, and professional IT support. It's why Centricom is now our area's number one internet provider. Add internet to your bundle and save. Call or visit centricom.com today.
is a good day to be alive in the STG.
You would have lost your mind.
I could not believe he
didn't. Southern Utah's connection to the world of sports is Sports Radio 97.7 ESPN. Southern Utah's home for the best in sports includes local high school games, Dixie State University, the NBA's new look, Utah Jazz, plus the best of the National Football League. With the worldwide presence of ESPN, to the Devin Dixon Show every afternoon from 4 to 6.
I will be, or welcome back. I said we are back. Here we are once again. All right, guys, quick look. What do you think? What do you anticipate is going to happen here in the second half?
Well, the first quarter, Bear River had some trouble with their transition D, some of our Camping World keys, and they couldn't keep Dixie out of the middle. That all changed with the 1-3-1. So Dixie's got a rebound and run, and then they can't get back in that 1-3-1 and get really set. So, and then when they are in the half-court set, because Dixie's going to have to face it some more, I don't see Bear River pulling out of it. They might change it up. They're going to have to do a better job of finding some open space. And like Andy said, they've got to be able to knock down some angle threes because that's where the soft spots are.
Yeah, there are some soft spots in that 1-3-1 zone. You've got to have Crockett, Dykes, even Otis, and Bennett step up and be able to hit those threes on the corners. And then the one thing maybe we haven't talked about much, Dixie turned the ball over a lot in that second quarter. They've got to take better care of the basketball.
All right, so the Bears will have it to start the second half, and they have a 7-point lead at 29-22 here in this semifinal action from the 3A championships here in Cedar City. Ball comes into Tristan Hartfell. He'll walk it into the forecourt. Dixie starts it in a man-to-man. Does he give it up on the angle? Shot no good. Rebound taken down by the Flyers. Quickly down court they go. Long cross-court pass to Bennett in the corner. They switched out. It's a 2-3 matchup.
Yeah, 2-3 instead of 1-3-1.
And now Dixie's taking a look at it like, okay, now what do we do here?
You still got those angle threes that are going to be open.
Bounce it inside, back out. Bennett rises. Three short off the rim. Rebound Hartfell.
Bennett shot 2 threes. One was really long. That one was really short. Hopefully you can find the middle eventually.
Top of the key straight away. Bounce it to the high post. They went with the double high post. Backing it out now is Litchford. Litchford holds on, sets the screen, jumper, bank, no. Rebound, nice job inside Guyman.
I bet he's got 8 or 9 already in this game.
To Bennett. Bennett down the left side. He'll bounce it across. In the corner it goes, but no shot there. High post, turn around, 15-footer down the lane, no good. Rebound goes to the corner. A battle force taken away by the Bears.
Good look by Early, but a great rebound by Sorensen. He's played well.
Hartfell straight away goes left wing. Nolly gets it back. Hartfell. Back and forth. Man to man by Dixie. They bounce it into the corner. Bears with the ball and a 7-point lead. They back him out. He rises from way downtown and buries it.
Hit it from the parking lot, as I like to say. That was deep.
Yeah, that was from Enoch maybe or Perelman.
And it's a 10-point lead, 32-22. Bears putting big-time pressure on Dixie. 6:08 to go here, down to the baseline.
I don't understand why Crockett's not shooting that look. He's had open looks again and again.
And the ball is tipped twice, out of bounds. Last touch by Buse of the Bears. And the Flyers will have it on their own baseline.
Yeah, I don't know either, Andy. They are good looks, and he's one of the best shooters in Region 9.
Oh, and they go inside. Bennett tried to just catch and shoot, and it didn't go. And a rebound taken down by the Bears. Hartfell straight away. Backs the dribble out. Looks for a screen, gets it. Goes all the way to the base, inside. Blocked out of there nicely done, Guyman.
I think that's his first block tonight, isn't it? And he had, I think, 6 of them yesterday in the game. He's a great shot blocker. I guess if the other team's shooting threes all the time, you're not going to block too many shots.
That's a pretty good job. He had no backside help that time, so it's a good thing he got there. As the ball comes in to Hartfell. Hartfell gets it inside. Lean-in shot up and in. Litchford, his first bucket of the night. And it's a 5-0 start for the Bears here in the third quarter. And a mistake by Dixie. Boy, went right through the hands of Malachi Otis, and that's unusual.
And Coach Cuff is going to let him play out of this. Some coaches would take a timeout, try to refocus his team. He's going to let him play on. But, yeah, just took his eyes off the ball. Too many turnovers for the Flyers.
Into the forecourt goes Buse. Buse finds Hartfell. Hartfell drives right midway to the corner. Keeps the dribble alive. Bounces it into corner up. Cross off, no good. Rebound Crockett. Ahead it comes to Otis. Otis hustles. Right wing stops. Kicks it back. Round to Bennett. Down low on the base underneath. Bennett backside shot. No, and a foul.
Tyler Bennett a little frustrated. I think he thought he got fouled. You know that inbounds play, they use that all year long. A little lob into Bennett, and he never even comes down with it. He just catches and tips it in. And that time, I think he really felt like they got a lot of arm contact on it. Referee said play on. In fact, when we played 3 minutes here, there's only been one foul, the one we just saw.
Go ahead.
I was just going to thank some of our great local partners like Fabulous Freddy's, our free throw sponsor this year. Fuel it up, wash it down, and save. And both Southern Utah locations.
That's the first point of the second half, by the way, guys, right now for the Flyers.
Take the Mustang in, get it shined up at Freddy's, huh?
Yeah.
I will.
Somebody will buy me a Mustang, I'll take it down and get it shined up at Freddy's, too. I'm just saying.
All right.
4:54 to go. Bennett, second free throw. It's up and in and out, no good. 13 points tonight for Tyler Bennett, leading all scorers. Pressure in the backcourt. Swing it cross court to Dally. Dally trying to bounce it down the baseline. And knocking it out of bounds was Dykes. And then he kind of ran over one of their players.
And I like what Coach Guff's doing. He's extending it out. He's really using the quickness of his guards to slow down Bear River's offense. Kind of a little counterpunch here.
Sorensen to Hartfell. Hartfell way outside. They come out with a trap. But the Bears break it down to the baseline. Lean back shot, no good. Rebound by Bennett. Bennett off and running. Left side back to the middle. Splits the D. Scoop it up and in.
And maybe that'll get the Flyers going with Tyler Bennett. Slicing and dicing and finishing with a finger roll.
He's so good at not charging on those. He goes around guys and contorts his body and then lays it in.
Ball comes finally into the forecourt. Buse gets it down baseline. They go across. The ball is ripped out of the hands and taken by Otis. Malachi, down he goes, in the lane, shot, no, and a rebound underneath to Buse.
Sometimes you got to pull it out, little guy. Yep. He had three big guys back, took them all on.
Kick it to the right side. Bears instead pull it back, and they'll reset. It's 34-25. Jumper off the mark, no good. Rebound taken down by Guyman.
They're letting them play, Mike.
Yep, they are.
That was pretty rough.
Gets it to Bennett. He splits, and we got a blocking foul, and Bennett went down hard. He'll be all right. Well, he split the defenders, but one of them kind of caught him on the hip, put him to the hard court, but the foul's going to be whistled on Bridger Buse, his second.
Tyler laying there for a second and realized if I stay down any longer, they're going to blow the whistle.
Yeah.
I'm going to have to leave the game, and I won't get to shoot my free throws.
Appreciate our friends at Dr. Cody Johnson's office, Johnson Pediatric Dentistry. Him and his staff make your kids feel right at home. See why so many are choosing Johnson Pediatrics. And every time your kids check out cavity-free, they get a ticket to go into big drawings like iPads and movie tickets and fun things. Ask for the new patient special, 628-0511.
Got a little bit of blood on Hartfield, and he – Now, the rule is you got to go out of the game and get that taken care of. And they were going to hold up the game for just a second, Mike. But instead, they said, oh, no, you got to take him out.
Yep.
You got to get him fixed, and then he can come back in. That's the right rule. The referees are doing the right thing here.
And he went out, and then he ran down the hall into the locker room.
Yeah, down to the trainer's room. They got a nice little trainer's room down here in that tunnel. And two full-time trainers on call at all times. So he'll get that taped up. He'll be right back.
Bennett back to the free throw line, shot up and in. Bennett has the only points in the game for Dixie since the first quarter. How about that?
Yeah.
And that's not good.
I think other guys are a little gun shy. I really do.
I'm with you. He hits them both.
Yeah, but, you know, you look at guys like Otis and Crockett. These guys have experience, Devin. I mean, they shouldn't be gun shy. They've been here before, too.
Yeah, you're right. But so far, Crockett hasn't taken but one shot.
I think so.
Dixie extended that to defense. They went about a three-quarter press. Bears break it down in the forecourt. They go in the lane. Shot comes loose. Picked up. Kicked back out. Jumper on the way. Off the mark. No good. Rebound Bears. And the ball was knocked away. Good call by the official because Elzy was actually standing out of bounds when he blocked the ball.
Well, I like what Dykes and Hera did. They said, okay, you got that rebound. We're going to make you score over both of us. And they both went straight up. And really almost got a steal for the Flyers. Just got that size 12 on the baseline.
Hera comes back out as they bring Larkin in.
Yeah, Guyman's sitting extended time. I don't know if he's not feeling well or just a little bit winded.
This is a fast-paced game right now. On the right wing, midway the corner, Sorensen. He goes down low, spin in the lane. They reach, they grab, and they get a foul. Triple team down on the low block. And let's see, the personal is going to be on Larkin. That'll be his first.
He didn't need to get his hands down there. Yeah, Dykes in there reaching for the ball cleanly. And he just needed to go up high and provide a little bit of a backstop in the way for the shooter. Instead, he put his hands down there and got the foul.
Litchford shot up and in.
You know, guys, I'm amazed at how quick games go and when they're this big. I mean, we're already late third quarter. It's crazy.
2:56 to go in the quarter. Shot up and in. Litchford hits a pair. And that's the first two free throws of the game for the Bears.
And they made a living at the free throw line in that Snow Canyon game yesterday. They were there often. Both teams were in the double bonus pretty early in the second half.
Back to the 1-3-1 defense. Bennett tries to break it down, goes to the baseline. They bump him, no harm, no foul. They work it around to the other side. Straight away, come back. Bennett will penetrate. Fall back, 10-footer, rims back in.
Got in close, felt the defense was there, and then faded away and got the friendly shooter's touch.
And anybody else, it's probably a terrible shot, but not for Bennett.
Long pass down as they kick it back, and there's a walk. They got him. I think he might have tripped Litchford, but he took that extra step, and the ball goes back. It is 36-29 with 2:16 to go.
Tough catch for a big man running full speed, and then you got to either put it on the bounce or make a move around a guy going straight up, trying to maybe take a charge or alter a shot.
And credit Coach Cuff of Dixie High for putting the press in. Maybe not forcing a ton of turnovers, but forcing Bear River to think about things a little more.
Yeah.
And like you said there, forcing a big guy to make a decision on the run.
Then he quickly hustles most of his start. I think he's all back to the starters right now. So they switch back, 2:10 to go, 36-29 in favor of the Bears. Crockett around the horn to Bennett. Bennett kind of fakes the three. Crockett left wing. Again, Dixie gets it into the corner. Early rises. It's a two-pointer, said the official.
He's the mid-range assassin, isn't he? That's his shot, Devin.
And he's confident. He's the one other guy that's confident to take a shot right now. No hesitation, catch and release, pretty rotation, that baseline 17-footer.
Bears break it down now, get into the forecourt. They go to the high post and down the lane. Shot, no, but a foul is going to be whistled on the Flyers. That's on Bennett.
Can I say this, guys? It is actually kind of refreshing that they're letting him play in this ball game. Too often we see big games like this. You're in the double bonus in the third quarter. Well, here we are, third quarter. There's two team fouls each.
And I don't think they even had a combined 3-4 fouls in the first half.
Let him play, as long as it doesn't get too rough.
At the line is Michael Litchford. Lines it up, it's on the way, and buries it. So Litchford.
That's one out of two, Mike, and Dixie now just really two possessions down if they can hit a three.
37-31 in the corner. They bring it back out, swing it up top to Otis. Malachi on the angle, down low to the base. Early kicks it out. Crockett bounces it to Otis. He's looking, they want Bennett. And a man on the defense down there is Gunnar Sorensen. Shot short, no good off the rim.
Well, you got to make shots to have the press work. And on a miss, you don't have the most coaches will not have the press. And so Bear River can walk it across now, under a minute to go.
37-31, a 6-point lead. Hart foul, back and forth. He'll step up, 15 footer from the elbow right side. And Hartfeld puts it down.
Got a nice roll. Big guy wanted to touch it.
Team Diotto three, there he goes. Crockett rises and buries one.
He was just waiting for the big moment. Just waiting for the big moment to hit a big three.
And they break it down. They get it all the way down underneath, and Gunner has a layup.
Yeah, you got to have a goalkeeper in those press situations. Nobody was back.
41-34, a 7-point lead. The Bears keeping that distance.
And they like to use Tyler Bennett or Malachi with about 10. And they don't always set a pick. Sometimes they will go high pick.
Time to go, running out.
Bennett loses the ball, gets it off. Trying to force the shot, no harm, no foul, say the officials. And that's it, third quarter comes to an end. And it is the Bears, they lead it 41-34. Back with quarter four in a minute.
In times like these, a small business has to work smart to make it. Centricon can help. We've got the business class services you need for less. We're the fastest small business internet speeds available today. The reliability of 24-hour network monitoring and superior tech support. And our commitment to grow when you do with scalability that's both fast and flexible on our own fiber optic network. Make the smart choice. Call or visit centricom.com today.
Logan Regional Orthopedics provides excellent care, all the resources available.
Having a full-service hospital so close is very helpful.
I think our level of caring and expertise set us apart.
We've stayed current, and we've demonstrated that we are certified.
We offer patients the ability to treat almost anything here in the Valley.
Everybody is committed to providing you the best quality of care to allow you to get back and doing the things that you want to do.
Logan Regional Orthopedics and Sports Medicine, healing for life.
One quarter to go. One of these teams will be in the state championship game tomorrow. The other will have to see if they can settle for third at best. And right now a 7-point lead to the Bears. And for Dixie, they kind of become a one-man scoring team with 19 of the 34, Tyler Bennett.
Yeah, you got some other guys that do have a couple of field goals. Erdley, Crockett's got two threes. But Bennett, man, he is a one-man wrecking ball right now. But they're trying to take him away. He's not able to get all the way to the rim against that zone. And so other guys are going to have to make some key shots if Dixie is going to overcome this 7-point deficit. Put eight on the Air Care Professionals clock. I'm ready for fourth quarter basketball. Pressure on the Flyers a little bit here. But the Bears have to continue to play well. They built this lead, but Dixie can be streaky. And they got to be careful here not to let Dixie get too much momentum.
A little bit of moisture on the court. That's why the holdup as they try to get that all mopped up and fixed. I'm with you. And the thing about Bennett, he's a great scorer. He's a great guy. But I guarantee every one of those Bear River guys knows about number five for Dixie. And that's why you see when he starts to penetrate, they collapse three guys on him. That's why you need shooters who can step up and punish them for the triple.
And we've seen glimpses of that. We saw Guyman get that dunk early in the first half. We saw that Crockett three when he was open, early that baseline jumper. Just haven't seen enough of it, and that's why the Flyers trail.
So we're underway here in the fourth quarter. Flyers trail, but they have the basketball. Backing it out now is Malachi Otis. Gives it to Erdley. Across the high post, back to Erdley again in the corner. Wide open look on the way, front rim, no good. Rebound hauled in by the Bears.
And they have rebounded the ball well in this game. Every miss, they seem to be able to clear it.
Ball was knocked away and stolen away. And then stepping on the end line was Malachi Otis when he tried to save it back in. But the first job, good one by Richard Guyman to get back.
Yeah, the speed of Otis is fun to watch. He just shoots around like a missile.
He and Elzy have quick hands, too.
41-34. A little fallback, 16-footer up and good. You can't give Hartfell that close of a shot.
Got a nice screen, though. Freed him up.
He did.
Defender didn't fight through it.
Erdley down low to the baseline. Drive, throws it back. Erdley cuts it. Like, I don't know what to do with this thing. Now to Crockett. Crockett, skip it cross court to Otis. Malachi will penetrate down to the baseline. Up top, in the corner, Otis. You notice who hasn't touched the ball this time down?
Tyler Bennett.
And we've got a foul underneath.
Yeah, they're going to get Litchford there. Yep. Just a little bump. Coach Hunt doesn't like it. I didn't see it.
Well, they threw it away. I think he was mad. Now we've got an offensive foul on Dixie. And James Erdley with the personal. That's his first.
A lot of basketball left, 7 minutes on the clock. And Dixie really needs someone else. I think that's one of the reasons Bennett didn't touch it on that last possession. Yeah, it was good defense on him. But I think also Coach Cuff is trying to get other guys involved and get their confidence going. Confidence is such a funny thing.
So the Flyers trail right now 43-34. By the way, in the game is Zach Hera for the Flyers.
Yeah, Elsie back out there as well.
Yep. And a 10-second count.
Yeah, he stopped. He stopped. Yeah. He saw the trap coming, stopped a foot or two shy of the timeline there at half court, and it cost the Bears possession.
Now, I think every time here in the fourth quarter, though, the Flyers have got to take advantage of any miscue like that. They need to get some shots up. Only four buckets in the second half so far.
Yeah, you get a stop. You definitely need to come out and capitalize.
Early looking for help, dumps it in the corner to Crockett. Crockett brings it out. Cross court pass to Early. Early looks down low, nobody there.
This zone really takes its toll on time of possession, too. You have to be patient.
Oh, wide open look down a barrel, and Early buries it.
He's ready to play. He wants a piece of the action. Nice 15-footer from straight away for James Early.
Full court pressure once again, but they break it down. 43-36, 7-point lead for the Bears. Penetration all the way to the hole. Lifts it up. No. Bennett with the rebound. Flyers off and running. Bennett, one against two. That's not fair. Bennett, though, can't get it to go down that time. And when I said not fair, I meant it wasn't fair for the Bears. He usually can take two.
Yeah, I thought they did a pretty good job. Instead of trying to take a charge, which you see a lot of guys do in that situation, they stayed ready and they stayed on their feet and just kind of jumped at the ball when he threw it up. Pretty good defensive set for Bear River.
Yep, the foul is on Bennett. That's his second.
You know, sometimes I really like to stop and pop three in that situation because you got two guys racing back defensively. The transition defense for Bear River has been absolutely fantastic.
Nearly with the steal. The ball is tipped, but the Bears get it. Ooh, they had a guy alone underneath. That was Litchford, but they didn't get it to him. And we got a reach and a foul, I believe, on Elzey. It is.
Sorensen likes to lead with that left arm out a lot, and some officials will call that, some won't. We saw yesterday against Spokane, they didn't call it on him once. That time I really thought he led with his arm. It should have been an offensive foul.
Ball will be out of bounds to the Bears underneath their own bucket. Trying to trigger it in to get it into the corner. Catch and shoot, short, no good by Hartfell. Ahead it goes, one-on-one at the other end. A hard foul, but it didn't go in. The foul's going to be called on Gunnar Sorensen, and that will put Otis at the line.
Hurst Ace Hardware update from earlier today. If you're just tuning in, getting off work, appreciate Hurst, a hardware store, but so much more. Corner Boulevard Bluff in St. George, Main Street in Cedar City. Consolation game, Desert Hills beats Pineview. Snow Canyon falls to Logan. So Thunder will play the Grizzlies tomorrow morning, about 10:45. In the girls' games today, man, what a finish in that Cedar Redmond game as they win. They'll meet Snow Canyon, who also won earlier here at the Centrum.
Yeah, their star, Courtney Morley, missed two free throws with just a few seconds left, but they got the offensive rebound, and they were able to put that ball in with, I think, 1.6 seconds left, the game winner.
Malachi Otis went 1 for 2. That's his first points of the night, so it's a 6-point game. A lot of time, 5.5 to go. Ahead, the ball comes to Daly. Daly in the forecourt. Ball is ripped away by Elzey from behind. He's off to the races. Stop shot. Oh. No, he missed it.
But he reached in and got a jump ball. That's a fortunate call.
Yep.
You got to make that one, though. That's a layup on the run. You got the defender to fly by. It was pretty much uncontested, and he just short-armed it a little.
And Coach Hunt came racing out of his box, and now he's going to take a timeout.
Yeah, take a timeout.
He did not like that call. How did Elzey move? I mean, perfect jump stop to let the defender go by. Just didn't hit. It's magic. If you hit that top right square, it goes right through the hoop. He just missed it off a little bit.
1 minute break. We'll take it. 43-37. We're back in a minute.
The living room. It's a great place to watch TV. Just like your backyard. Break time at the office. Or while on the go. Now you can watch TV everywhere. Stream your favorite shows or live TV from many channels in your cable package on any computer, tablet, or smartphone. It's all included with Centricom Cable TV service for no extra cost. Sign up to watch TV everywhere today. Call or visit centricom.com to learn more.
For just $4, get a double cheeseburger, a spicy chicken sandwich, fries, and a Coke. It's the heavyweight champion of deals. The $4 Real Deal, only at Carl's Jr. All the flavors of a great steakhouse, now on a burger. The Steakhouse Thick Burger. Onion strings, blue cheese, and A1 sauce on 100% black Angus beef. Only at Carl's Jr.
5 minutes and 21 seconds to go in the ball game. It is 43-37, Bears up by six, and they have the basketball. Full court man-to-man press by the Flyers.
Well, they've really been jumping into this press off and on the entire second half. They're not waiting, being behind. They've been aggressive.
Ooh, just traveling, got away with it.
Yeah, big one right in front of the official, but hey, it doesn't count unless the official blows the whistle. Drive into the lane and a blocking foul is going to be charged on Early. Early tried to slide in, got there a little bit late.
Yeah, I know he didn't know this, but it actually would have been a turnover. The pass was knocked away after the foul, but well, it's still going to be Bear River ball. Sorry, Bear River folks. I know you don't like Logan.
All right. Bear River with the ball underneath. They get it in, hands it to Sorensen, right back now to Hartfell. Hartfell bounce it to Sorensen, inside kick out, and they'll take a little time off the clock now at 5 minutes with that 6-point lead. Pressure and losing the ball. No, they pointed the wrong way.
Dixie didn't touch the ball, Mike.
I know. And the official says, nope, I call it. That's the way it is. The Bears bench is standing up because they know they just got Christmas early.
Wow, couple breaks going the Bears' ways. Dixie can't let it rattle them, though. They're in position to mount a comeback.
Boy, Dixie aggressive on the defense. And now they're going to have a foul called on Elzy.
Well, I think he fouled him a couple of times earlier before the call.
See, and I don't. I thought they just bodied up and they trapped him there. They weren't reaching and they weren't grabbing arms. But the foul came late. I can see why Flyer fans would be frustrated. At the same time, Bear River fans agree with you, Andy. They're like, get him off. They're all over us. So that's a tough game to officiate right now. You can't cut the intensity in this arena with a knife.
And by the way, talk about how little fouls there were and stuff. We're now in the 1-1.
Yeah. The Flyers are having to get a lot aggressive. And the free throw up and good.
Yeah, if there's a guy you want at the line, it's 25, Hartfield. He is, you know, he's your shooter. He's the guy with a great touch. And if there's a situation where, you know, you want to take a foul, you're going to take a foul, get it in 25's hands.
He'll step back up, one more coming. And it's on the way, and it's in and out. No good. Rebound to the Flyers. Otis into the forecourt. Kick it back Curdley, right back to Otis. Spins, traveled, they got him.
I didn't think
tried the little jump stop. But remember, you got to lead from both feet and land from both feet if you're going to do that.
I don't understand.
Close call.
I just don't understand why Tyler Bennett's not getting the ball here. I mean,
yeah.
I know Malachi Otis is unbelievable with that spin move. He's been brilliant all year, but you got to get touches for Tyler Bennett. Now you're going to give him a quick breather. And Tyler just said something to Coach Cuff, like, give me the ball. Get me back in. Coach Cuff's pretty fired up, too.
Yeah, very fired up, as a matter of fact. Ball comes in, collision. There's the offensive charge. That time, he stepped up. Running over him was Gunnar Sorensen. Second foul on Sorensen.
He guessed right. He just picked the spot, beat him there. And the official just 3 feet away. Emphatic charge call.
I'm sure the Bears fans were thinking, well, he got pushed from behind. That's why he did it. But certainly a charge in the front end.
Bennett right back into the ball game. He inbounds the ball.
He set out for 12 seconds.
Yeah. Up top, get it to Bennett. Bennett. Inside Early. Early looking for Bennett. Bounces it off. Penetration now to Early. Down low on the base. Kick it back out. Flyers got to move the ball a little quicker. Team Diotto. Three from the wing right side. Otis buries it.
Remember that three he missed early in the game? It was wide left by a foot. This one he buries between the eyes.
Another travel. Yep. Good call. A little late, but a good call. He tried to step through the double team without dribbling.
That time I was watching Coach Hunt. I think he knew that one because he just stepped down and goes, okay, guys, okay. But it is now a 4-point game. This is a huge possession with 4:01 to go in the ball game.
You know, they say defense wins championships. I'll tell you what, Dixie's defense has kept them in this game. It could very easily be a 15-point lead if their defense hadn't played so well.
In the corner, Crockett back to Bennett. He swings it out to Eardley to Bennett.
1-3-1 again,
yep,
Mike.
It is. Now to Crockett, to Bennett. They reverse it. 3:47 to go.
There he is.
Down low on the baseline to get it to the big guy. He tries to penetrate, and he steps on the end line.
Crockett is still a little hesitant, yeah, in shooting the ball, and he's open, Devin, on the corner
and
there.
And so is Guyman. Guyman's getting the baseline bounce to him a couple of times, about 8-10 feet out, but he doesn't want to extend into the guy. He needs to take that little baby little jump hook. He can shoot it from 10 feet out. He's got the height. They're not going to block that shot. But credit again, Bear Rivers' zone defense really making things difficult for Dixie.
They get it into Hartfell. Hartfell swings it cross court. Still in the back court, Hartfell now into the forecourt. They break the press. Bears drive, collision. No harm, no foul. Wait a minute, what's the call?
That's a bad call. Connor Dykes there, he took it and then waited, and then the whistle came after he saw it miss. And Bear River had the rebound. I don't understand that call whatsoever. Let the Bears play on if you're going to go no call.
Well, two things. That circle doesn't count in high school. There is no protection circle underneath the basket, so that shouldn't have been a factor. And then the other thing, the whistle was so late. It's either a foul or it's not. You can't wait to see if the shot goes in.
Shot no good by Dolly.
Again, though, not to be critical, but it's a tough game. You know, both these teams are making big plays. They're taking stands. They're trying to take charges. I mean, this is what state basketball is all about.
Dolly's taking free throw up and good. It's a five-point lead at 45-40. Flyers, Bennett down the near side. He backs it out, cross court. Team Diotto three is off the mark. Tipped up and in, Bennett!
That's a little volleyball two-handed tip.
Bears quickly into the forecourt. It's 45-42, three-point lead Bears. And they get it down the baseline. Ball is knocked away. Crockett, and it goes off the Bears.
Yeah, Dixie flashed in front of him. He lost vision of the ball for just a second, and it hit off his fingers and out of bounds.
If Litchford gets that tough catch, he's got a tiny little Crockett that he's going to score easily over. But that's a little frantic right now. Everything's just a little off sync because both teams have pressure defense.
Dykes into the game. They go around to Bennett. Bennett in the corner gets it right back. Two-man game on the wing. Now it comes back to Otis. Team Diotto three, Dykes buries every time.
And that's the shot, Devin, that Crockett has not been taken. It's been there all game long. We're tied.
And into the fourth, Hartfell. Drive, hang, underneath, layup, good. Boy, they got it on the low block, Dolly, and he laid it in.
Now they got to the middle. When you get to the middle, you got that easy pass because everybody's converging on you.
Bennett goes all the way to lay it in, and they say no basket.
Well, that's good in college and the pros, but the officials waved it off on the bump. Bennett glides so quickly down the lane. He covers so much ground with those big strides that it was just inside the free throw line where the foul occurred. He just took one step and then finished, but they wave it off.
Coach Cuff lobbying a little bit for the three-point play. Not going to get it. It'll be Dixie ball, two-point game here. What's the holdup?
Well, they're trying. Up on the board, it says
16 fouls.
They said it was on number three. Oh, he is in there. Okay. That's Jacob Dolly with the foul. 16 fouls, you're right. So it's flyer ball out of bounds underneath their own basket. Comes out to Guyman. Guyman turns. Gets it into Bennett. He swings it out. Eardley bumped. It'll be a three-shot foul.
Yeah, I thought that was Dykes out there, and I was almost guaranteeing it was going in, but it was Eardley brave enough to take that three-point shot, and he got hit right on the arm on the three. I wonder if James Eardley can hit three free throws in a row in this situation. Devin, could you?
Yeah, I could.
No.
Yeah,
no.
I was 85, no. And Eardley's capable of it, Andy. It's all about concentration. But it's
well,
a big
moment.
He won't
get three, will he?
That one looked a little flat, didn't it? That was kind of on a clothesline.
It was flat and hard, and, you know, you got to focus front rim, young fella, not back rim.
Well, your heart's beating 90 miles an hour, your frantic pace, and then you got to just slowly collect yourself, take deep breaths, and both those right on line, just long.
Hurting themselves right here, obviously, with missed a couple. Got one more coming up.
That changes everything from leading to trailing.
He gets the third, so it's a one-point game, 47-46. As back in the game comes Connor Dykes. Erdley will sit down.
I think Coach Cuff saw him confidently knock down that triple, and now he wants him in.
Yeah. Full court man-to-man pressure. They go deep ball. Back there to knock it away, but it is saved by the Bears. They get it back in to Sorensen. Has a shot away, Bennett's alone. Down he goes for the hammer dunk.
And this place is going nuts.
Flyers lead, Tyler Bennett. He's gonna be the MVP of the state if Dixie wins it. He probably is anyway, showing you his skill set. He's not just a shooter, he's not just a slasher. He can defend and then throw down in transition. My oh my, that was special.
And it's a full one-minute break. Let's take it. Now it's Dixie 48, Bear River 47. We're back in a minute.
It is a good day to be alive in the STG.
I could not believe he didn't.
Southern Utah's connection to the world of sports is Sports Radio 97.7 ESPN. Southern Utah's home for the best in sports includes local high school games, Dixie State University, the NBA's new look, Utah Jazz, plus the best of the National Football League. With the worldwide presence of ESPN, to the Devin Dixon Show every afternoon from 4 to 6.
Want to make your HDTV even better? Centricom has the HD channels you want. Our HD DVR gives you total control of your experience. And we're always adding new channels to serve you better. Why settle for less? Get our full HD lineup, now with over 61 HD channels. Call or visit us online and get the best HD experience from Centricom.
Two minutes and 1 second to go in the game, and we got a game, 48-47 Flyers.
I'll tell you what, if you're a fan, you're like, what can I design to have this be the most exciting game? How about a Bennett steal when we're behind and dunking with 2 minutes left? That's exactly what you want, right, guys?
It's what we got. We'll go story for that. All right, Bears have it. They try to get it inbounds, finally go deep into the backcourt, and the Flyers will start it off with a man-to-man pressure. Elzy on defense. They go top of the key. Shot no good. Rebound knocked away.
Good
and
call.
A foul.
Good call. Guyman's been slapped on the rebounds all game long, but he's done a great job of holding on to it. That time he couldn't hold on because they separated his right arm from the basketball. Now, a lot of pressure on the big fella. Big guys traditionally not great free throw shooters.
Although I think Guyman is not bad. He's getting better, but he has one bucket, 2 points, no free throw attempts in the game.
And he won't get a second one if he misses the first one, because it's a true one-on-one.
Guys, as big as that Tyler Bennett for President dunk was, I don't know, we might not have seen our AWP Playmaker Play of the Game, but that's sure our top candidate.
Guyman misses it. And the ball knocked out of bounds. It belongs to the Bears.
Yeah, Erdley tapped it, and I think James Erdley's like, well, I hit it off of his hand, though. So official giving it to the Bears, though.
Bears have it out of bounds. Ball comes in the backcourt. That is Jacob Daly. He holds on now, hands to Hartfell. Hartfell across the 10-second line into the forecourt.
Fans standing up, guys. I love it.
Drive in, shot up, three bounces, no good. Rebound, Bennett underneath. A minute 28 to go in the ball game. And the Flyers with a one-point lead. Long cross-court pass, Otis. Otis gives it back to Elzy, now to Bennett.
They're gonna trap if they can.
Yep. That's some pretty good guys out there to beat the trap. Ball is knocked away and out of bounds. It belongs to Dixie, but that can happen at any time.
Dixie likes this, though. When they can play keep away, you gamble one time and you come up short, then they can get numbers and they can attack and maybe make it a three-point game.
Plus, Tyler Bennett is so good at one-on-one. If he gets escapes and gets a one-on-one situation, he will score.
And Malachi Otis is grabbed and held in the backcourt.
I was just about to say, I don't think Coach Hunt's going to go very long without fouling, because he's not going to let this game just get out of hand.
And you know, guys, when it's an 8-point game, a 6-point game, fouling rarely helps. You end up losing by more. But when it's a 1-point game with a minute left, I think it's a really wise decision.
Yeah, no matter what, one possession.
Malachi Otis 1-for-2 in the game. He has 4 points. He's stepping up there for some big free throws. Got it.
Oh, and that first one going through feels good as a shooter from the line. That really makes that second one a little bit easier.
And that was the last true one-and-one, so it'll be two shots from here on out for Dixie with any fouls. Dixie only has 18 fouls, so there'll be one more one-on-one if they foul.
Second one on the way, good again. Otis hits up there. It's a three-point lead for the Flyers, 50-47, under a minute to go. Driving, hanging, ball is blocked away from behind. Otis picks it up, he's off to the races. Put it up, no, but a foul.
Yeah, you can't, for Bear River, you can't afford to give up the 2 points. So you go hard and make sure he does not score. I don't think it was a dirty play or anything. They contested the shot, but certainly a lot of body
hard
on the
foul. But I like, I mean, yeah, you're going to say, nah, I'm not giving you anything. So Otis will go back to the line. That is the third foul on Jacob Daly. And the free throw's on the way, and Otis has got it going on. Three in a row.
Yeah, he's making a late charge, isn't he? He's playing great.
Timeout taken.
It's a Rolling Stone timeout. You're home for decorative rock.
Full break, let's take it. 1 minute away, it's 51-47. We're back in one.
Logan Regional Orthopedics provides excellent care, all the resources available.
Having a full-service hospital so close is very helpful.
I think our level of caring and expertise set us apart.
We've stayed current, and we've demonstrated that we are certified.
We offer patients the ability to treat almost anything here in the Valley.
Everybody is committed to providing you the best quality of care to allow you to get back and doing the things that you want to do.
Logan Regional Orthopedics and Sports Medicine, healing for life.
High-speed Wi-Fi. Not quite as important as running water in your home, but close. Centricom powers your Wi-Fi network with consistent speeds to keep all your gadgets going strong. Streaming video players, laptops, tablets, even smartphones, so you're never stuck with those big cell data charges. And talk about value. Just pick your speed and keep the Wi-Fi flowing in your home at a great low price. Upgrade your internet today. Call or visit centricom.com to learn more.
Hi, we are back here in Cedar City. We're about 90% of the crowd up on their feet right now. Got a good one going on.
I know it's a tense moment because even Mike McGarry is on his feet.
I gotta
Mr.
stand
Calm,
to see.
Mr. Cool.
Ah, gotta watch that one.
So this is a utilitarian stand-up, not a tension one, huh?
Okay, maybe a little bit of both. What can I say here? Otis got the free throw.
Bear River doesn't have to have the three here, but they need something quick. Depends on what Dixie tries to give them.
By the way, it's a 15-4 run right now.
And the ball is rejected out of bounds, but a foul is going to be called. Richard Guyman gets the personal.
That's a tough call for the big guy. What are you supposed to do? Jump straight up in the air, and you block the shot, and they call a body foul on you.
But Hartfell, he didn't have the three because LZ popped way out and picked him up. So he went down the lane trying to get the quick two.
Boy, and they just took, what, 7 seconds? They got to the free throw line.
Free throw up and good. And again, he's the guy that you want there.
Exactly what you wanted for Bear River.
Yeah, exactly. But Guyman, I mean, you're a shot blocker. You're a rim protector. How do you just let him shoot it over you? You have to try to get the block.
Well, he just went straight up. I mean, it was a pretty good block.
Hartfell gets them both, so it'll be Flyer basketball.
And here comes some Bear River press now.
Yeah. They get it back to Bennett. Over to Elzy. Elzy back to Bennett. Boy, nearly threw that one away. Now they got to get it into the forecourt. And there's a foul in the middle of the lane. Michael Litchford gets the personal, and the Flyers back to the line with 28 seconds
How
to go.
How smart is this underclassman kid, Elzy? I mean, he knew the 10-second count was getting pretty close. He leads James Eardley, who catches it with an arm draped through. I mean, that was a great catch, like a receiver going over the middle against a pro safety.
Little dangerous pass, but he had to do it. You're right, they're running out of time.
And the free throw is good, James Eardley.
Now, didn't he just brick like two or three?
Well, he was one out of two. No, one out of three. You're right.
Yeah, when he got fouled on that three-pointer. Again, we'll be naming a Dats Trucking Player of the Game. Our AWP Playmaker Play of the Game. We got a lot of nominees, guys.
Early up and good. The free throws are falling for the Flyers. And timeout. Not sure what the official saw, but he's going
over. I think they rolled the ball, you know, so the clock wouldn't start, but the clock started anyway, so they're going to put a second or two on the clock.
It shows 28.1 up there. Okay, they put 0.7 back on the clock.
There you go. Every yep. six-tenths counts, right?
We'll find out here. Bears have the ball. They trail now by 5, 54-49, hustling into the forecourt. Hartfell down the lane, blocked out of there this time, cleanly grabbed by Elzy, and a foul on the Bears. And I think the Flyers getting a little excited now. What a block out there by Guyman.
Another nominee for our AWP Playmaker Play of the Game, going out on the jump shot and blocking it. I love shot blockers.
And it looked like maybe Hartfell should have maybe took a step back three. You know, he curled that screen, yeah. And I thought maybe he was going to take the triple to try to cut it to two. And instead, he goes in a little bit further, and that allowed Guyman to go up high and block him.
Caden Elzy to the charity stripe on the way, and he hits it.
You know, I interviewed him last week, and I said, Caden, how you, so many great players on Dixie, how are you carving out playing time? He says, I don't know, I'm just working my butt off trying to make my guys better. Good statement for a young guy.
He's kind of one of the guys that's burst onto the scene in Southern Utah, isn't he?
And the Flyers are not missing the free throws. Now, I know we got a break, but let's keep it right here. Make sure we don't miss anything down the stretch. We set the play. The Flyers have now built a 7-point lead, 56-49, with seconds remaining. And I tell you what, free throw shooting has been astounding.
Yeah, now every foul, both teams will be double bonus. The possession arrow is in Dixie's favor. So everything kind of leaning Dixie's way right now with just a few seconds left.
You know, and what's fantastic about this game is we were early on going, is anybody going to step up? Is anybody going to help Tyler Bennett? Elzy's been clutch. Otis has been clutch. I mean, Guyman's been clutch.
Dykesbury to triple. Erdley hitting the points. They've all stepped
they
up.
They all, when the moment got biggest, when they were down, they all started to rally. I'm so impressed with this Bear River philosophy. Coach Hunt's had his kids ready to go in this game, and they're not done yet, but they're going to need a quick three at this point in time. They got to get a quick three, go for a steal, and they got a foul within seconds to try to extend this game out down 7.
Devin leaned over to me during one of the timeouts. It was 43-37 Bear River. Gave me this look, ominous look, and said, they're going to be able to come back? And I said, yeah. Since then, 19-5.
I can
or
attest,
19-6.
I can attest. I did ask him what his thoughts were, and he did say he thought the Flyers would come back. They've been number one almost all season long. They're one of the favorites to win it, but Bear River's giving them all they wanted.
Comes in to, they kick it back. The deep three is in and out, no good. Down low, rebound, early foul. That'll do it, guys.
9 seconds left. Yep. Even if he misses both free throws, doesn't matter.
56-49. The Flyers are headed to the state championship game tomorrow. They won't know who they play until the final game tonight.
That could be the old Region 9 rival from years past, Canyon View. Canyon View hopes so, but they're playing a very, very good Juan Diego team.
Amen on that one. To the line, Erdley steps up and knocks it down. Now that basket just looks really big, you know?
Yeah, well, when
drop
you're,
it yeah, in the
you're
ocean.
Up 7 or 8 late.
Yep. Erdley steps up, next one on the way. That one is good again. 57-49, the lead is 8.
What a fourth quarter by the number one ranked Dixie Flyers.
Wow. Ball comes in, they'll let it roll, picked up. They apply some pressure, but they're not gonna foul. The three is no good, rebound Flyers, and that's it. They'll get it to Elzy. He runs away, Flyers! Headed to the state championship.
High drama, Devin, because Bear River was the perfect foil that, you know, to make this story that we put together in a semifinal game. Bear River came out, played well, played hard, had a great opportunity to get a win in this game, but it's the number one ranked team in the state who had the great fourth quarter and pulled away.
What a win. Huge win. Solid comeback. That's how state championships are won. Heart, determination. Flyers showed a lot of it in the fourth quarter, outscoring the Bears by a bunch, folks. I mean, they turned what was a huge deficit into what, if you just look at the paper tomorrow morning or read online, you're going to think Dixie won going away, but it wasn't that. It was a lot closer than the final score will indicate.
Yeah, great ball game. And I, you know, you were talking with the Bennett steal and dunk that gave Dixie the lead. You're like, there might be still, we might still have our AWP Playmaker play of the game. I don't think so. I think that was it.
Yeah, I agree. I agree.
I kind of like the block a little bit later.
It was nice. They were already up five at that point.
All right, let's take a 90-second break. We'll be back. We'll wrap this one up. And they got more coming up on the internet. Of course, we'll wrap it up on radio. The final 58-49 Dixie over Bear River. We'll be back in 90.
For just $4, get a double cheeseburger, a spicy chicken sandwich, fries, and a Coke. It's the heavyweight champion of deals. The $4 real deal, only at Carl's Jr. All the flavors of a great steakhouse, now on a burger. The Steakhouse Thick Burger. Onion strings, blue cheese, and A1 sauce on 100% black Angus beef. Only at Carl's Jr.
With internet service from Centricom, you get a fast, reliable connection to a world of information and inspiration. Just choose the bandwidth package that fits your needs and your budget. Every package delivers consistent speeds that bring the best of the web into your life. And we offer local, over-the-phone, technical, and professional IT support. It's why Centricom is now our area's number one internet provider. Add internet to your bundle and save. Call or visit centricom.com today.
It's a good day to be alive in the STG.
You would have lost your mind.
I could not believe he didn't.
Southern Utah's connection to the world of sports is Sports Radio 97.7 ESPN. Southern Utah's home for the best in sports includes local high school games, Dixie State University, the NBA's new look, Utah Jazz, plus the best of the National Football League. With the worldwide presence of ESPN, to the Devin Dixon Show every afternoon from 4 to 6.
All right, welcome back. We're just going to do a quick wrap-up here tonight. We got one more game coming up. We got to be out of the way, but let's just say what a comeback. What a fourth quarter for the Dixie Flyers. They win at 58-49. Outstanding night unofficially. 23 points for Tyler Bennett, 11 for James Eardley, also in double figures. But then everybody jumped in. Six strike at six strikes, two. Guyman, two. Elzey, 8 points. For Malachi Ota, six coming from the charity stripe.
Yeah, and you look at the Dash Trucking player of the game, I still think it's got to go to Tyler Bennett. I mean, he put them on their back in the second quarter, in the third quarter, and obviously the third quarter as well. Only 4 fourth quarter points. That's when some teammates stepped up. But Tyler Bennett, we were getting tweets, hashtag Dash Trucking MVP. I was getting tweets, Tyler Bennett for president.
Yeah.
Tyler Bennett is our Dash Trucking player of the game. We appreciate Dads. I think he gets the steal and the dunk, and that's probably the Appliance
like
Wholesalers
that,
Plus Playmaker play of the game as well. I would nominate Elzey for our Jimmy John Super Sub. I thought he came in and handled himself in a big moment in a big way.
Yeah.
Very admirable.
We don't see it in the stat book, but we saw it on the court here tonight.
Him or,
I like what Elzey
him or Dykes.
Did.
I thought Dykes came in and did a really good job too, but it's got to be one of those two guys probably off the bench that really provided the spark.
18 points tonight for Tristan Hartfield to lead the Bears, also in double figures. Gunnar Sorensen with 10, 8 to Daly, 6 to Jensen, and 5 to Michael Litchford. So that's going to do it. Winding it up tonight, 58-49. Dixie moves on. They will play in the state championship 12:30 tomorrow afternoon. And for the Bears, they play 30 tomorrow morning, isn't it?
Yeah, they'll play early tomorrow morning. It's a 9 a.m. tip is the time they'll play. If I'm not mistaken. And of course, we've got another big day tomorrow. We've got a couple more Region 9 teams. We'll have that Desert Hills game for you. We'll also bring you this state championship with Dixie and either Canyon View or Juan Diego. If you want to watch that game, it's on sportsradio977.com, centricom.com. Alex Huxberg is going to step in and do the play-by-play in that game. And of course, we got Dixie State basketball tomorrow night. Pack the Burns as they close out their home schedules. We got another big day tomorrow, Mike. We got to get some rest.
I know. We got to hurry home. By the way, it's 10:45 tomorrow morning for the Bears.
Yeah.
That is the third place game. That's going to do it for us. Thank you. We'll take a little break. We'll turn it right around for radio. We wind it up tonight for online. Stay tuned. More great action coming your way.